Good morning, Bear Creek, and thank you for worshiping with us today. Please stand and join us as we begin our praise and worship this morning. Here we go.
Your love so great, Jesus in all things. I've seen a glimpse of your heart a billion years. Still I'll be singing. How can I praise you enough? How can I praise you enough? You are the Lord Almighty, outshining all the stars in glory. Your love is like the wild. Savior, we are alive for your praise in earth and sky. No one is higher. Our God of wonders, you reign. Our God of wonders, you reign.
Here we go.
You are the Lord.
words fill our hearts today as we sing together.
I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty place and treasures that fade are never enough. And you came along and put me back together. And every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing. Nothing is better than you.
Better.
we come here today thankful for you are the only one who can. As the words in the song we just sang, Lord, there is no one greater than you. For you can turn our mourning into dancing. You can turn our sadness into happiness, Father. As we go in on our week, as we connect with you, Holy Father, allow us to also connect with those around us. As we find joy in our lives, as we find faith, as we find thankfulness this week, Holy Father, remind us to connect with each other. We thank you for all you do. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so very much. Will you give God a praise today? Thank you. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. So good to see all of you here on today. It's a beautiful, beautiful day that the Lord has given us. And I thank God for you all being here with us as well. What a magnificent time that God has given us to just worship the Lord. Amen. And I thank God for this beautiful, beautiful group that we have. Give them a hand too. I thank God for our praise team, our praise band. Thank you all so very much. Thank you. Welcome to Bear Creek United Methodist Church. This is a safe, inclusive faith community, and we are seeking and growing in Christ's love. Thank you all for joining us by way of live stream as well, being with us today. And register your attendance, please. Let us know that you are here with us. Some of you registered as you came in. You can also register on your Shelby app. Let us know that you are here. As we continue to be empowered by the Holy Spirit, God has given us all what we need to touch lives. And I can see, you know, doing that this week. And I pray that you saw that as well. Stay connected with us. We want to know what's going on with you. You can email us at stayconnected@bearcreekumc.org. Or you can also text me. Please text me with my mobile office number. That is 832-773-4901. So if you want to connect, let's do that as well. God is good. You guys feeling good today? A lot of good stuff going on. The library has a big day today. If you ever connected with our library, you understand there's a lot that we do during the year. But what we're having today is a big celebration of bringing a lot of the libraries around the Houston area together. It's the Houston Area Congregational Library Association, and we are going to host the event today at 2:30. If you want to know more of how to deal with everything that's been going on with the pandemic, we have a guest speaker that's going to be talking about that. So Amber and her team has been doing a great job, and I appreciate them. Looking forward to a great time today. Also, we are getting ready for our Harvest Festival and Trunk or Treat. It happens that it will be on October 31st, which falls on a Sunday. And so with our Trunk or Treat being on a Sunday, we figure we can all get in on it. It's just not right for the kids to have all the fun, right? And so what we're doing is we're going to start the Harvest Festival at 10 o'clock with a worship service. So please mark your calendar. One service on October 31st at 10 o'clock. We'll all meet here at 10 o'clock. And you can dress up just what your kids dress up. You dress up. I've already decided that'll be the last sermon in this series, so I'll be preaching on the Type 7s, which I'm a Type 7, so I'm going to dress up like the Type 7. Biblical character. You guys know who that is? Well, you have to find out. I'm going to dress up, okay? And all of us, we're going to just have a great time. After, we'll have some food. The United Methodist men, they'll be roasting our hot dogs, making sure we have some good hot dogs. And then we'll also have a setup with all of the trunk or treat is ready for. We'll be decorating our cars, our trucks, you know, just setting it up so we can have a lot. We want you to be a part of it. If you feel like decorating your vehicle and setting up, please get in touch with Susie so we can get all that done. It's going to be an exciting time. We're collecting candy already. I'm looking for a great time for our kids and for us as well. It's a good time for us to be alive, and looking around here, it's just good to see all of you. We had someone join the church this morning, so we've had somebody join the church at least in the last 3 to 4 Sundays. That's pretty good. This year, 21 people have joined the church, and so I want you just to continue to pray and ask God to continue to have more to be a part of this great family. Amen? Will you stand where you are? Look and see who you haven't seen in a while. Good to see you guys. I want to just say a big hello. Make sure you wave at somebody. Just give them a hug if you want, you know, air hug if you have to. But introduce yourself if you don't know them and you're very close to them. So it's good to see all of you here. You may be seated after you do all of that good stuff there. Jacqueline is going to join us today. Jacqueline is our preschool director, and she's been doing some exciting things with our kids. And so we are excited for a lot that's been going on, and she is going to give us a presentation. All yours, Jacqueline. Give a good warm welcome. Will you do that?
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. So we've had a really sweet year this year. Our preschoolers are the sweetest, and you're going to get a little treat in a few minutes where you'll get to hear them. They wanted to give you a little surprise this morning. But now that COVID restrictions are easing a little bit, our special events are back, chapel is back, and chapel has been my favorite part of the school year. We do chapel in here, and Emily dances and sings if you've ever gotten a chance to see her. She's really fun. So Emily dances and sings, and this past Wednesday, Pastor did our chapel, and he did such a beautiful job. So we've decided every year that all of our children are going to receive a Bible, and teachers will sign it, pastor will sign it, I'll sign it, and it'll act like a little memory yearbook that they'll be presented when they graduate. But what I loved about it as a mom, my daughter goes here, and there's her sweet little picture of her receiving her Bible. She went home and said, Pastor said God loves me. Pastor said I'm special. And he gave me a special book. And she went home remembering that God loves her. And so as a mom, it's beautiful. And as a director, it's beautiful. And I really hope this year that some of you get to join us at some of our special events to see how sweet our little ones are. And since you can't join us yet, I want to show you a little bit about what we're working on. And I have a video for you. These are our pre-K 3 and pre-K 4 students that are performing a song that we sing every chapel. Doing a great job this year. So if you ever want to stop by and say hi, we'd love it. If you'd like to see the preschool, I'm happy to show you. I'll be out in the lobby after church, but we'd love it if you guys ever wanted to stop by and say hi.
Thank you. Come on, good job. And all the little ones ahead. Thank you so very much. I appreciate it. You know, we have over 100 kids this year, and we are just going to continue, I believe, to expand and pray that you will help us as well. Lupi, come on, and we're going to ask God as we prepare for our giving. We want to continue to give and support all the ministries that God has blessed here at Bear Creek. Think about how God has blessed us. Think about all the things that have been done and what's going on. Lupe and I were in our class on yesterday. You know, we are taking spiritual direction classes. This is our second year into it. And it was just great. It was a beautiful day. So on our break, we actually took a picnic. That was fun. And so we get to do this every once in a while. We just kind of like for our lunch break, we just we have some time, just the two of us, and hang out. And one thing we had been talking about that morning was our Jewish roots. And that one scripture that really says everything for how Christianity and what God is trying to say to us in Deuteronomy chapters 6, verses 4 through 7, he starts it and he says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. That's the first thing he tells us. And then God goes on to say that we should love the Lord our God with all of our heart, with all of our mind, and with all of our might. One thing I realize is that God wants us to be balanced in all of our thinking, our feeling, and our doing. And the more God makes us one with each other, and that's what I found out as we were talking, the more God makes us one with who we are, one with God, we're able to become one with one another. And I've seen that here at Bear Creek, that we're able to see ourselves in others. That's why the food pantry is such a big thing, because we don't just give food, we see the hunger in others. Because we know what it might feel like, right? So you allow yourself to be that person. With the children, it is so good to see our kids and how we can minister to our kids, because how many of you can remember being that kid and what you needed and what it felt like? We're finding that in everything that we do, that we're able to allow ourselves to see the other person, to feel the other person. I want us to know that God is going to use us continually here at Bear Creek to bring in individuals because they feel that we feel them. They see that we see them. And that's important for us to continue to do that. Amen? Let's support the ministry here at Bear Creek and know that God is using us mightily to make a difference. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, thank you so much for Bear Creek. Thank you so much for what you're doing here in this work, Lord Jesus. It's you. It's not us, Lord Jesus. We surrender and allow your will to be done. Work through us, God, please. Continue to use us so that souls might be saved, that people may be healed, that needs may be met, Father, that people are drawn closer to you and closer to one another, we pray. In your Son, Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. Remember, the Lord loves a cheerful giver, so as you give today, smile. Thank you, sweetie. Jonathan is going to come with our prayer.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Just for a second, indulge me. I want you to close your eyes. And as you close your eyes, I want you to imagine God standing before you. And the same message that Pastor told that little one, God is telling you right now, he's saying, you are special and you are loved. It doesn't matter what you've done or what you're going to do, just know that you will forever be loved. And I want you to just to embrace that, because when you're embracing it, you're also feeling God hugging you. And he's letting you know it's okay to let go. Father, we love you so much. We love you because you extend past what we've done and you see us for who we are. And that's your child. Father, you embrace us and you hold us close. And so today, Father, if someone needs to hear the message that you are special, that you are loved, Father, that you are there embracing them right where they are. Father, we ask that you embrace our parents who are raising up children in the way that they should go. We ask that you embrace our teachers who are giving our students knowledge to make wise decisions. And then, Father, we ask that you embrace this congregation. Whether in this room or online, Father God, you embrace them and you let them know that they're never alone. Father, we give ourselves to you. We want to hear your voice. And as we do so, what we're hearing is that you are loved. So, Father, as we get ready to continue with this service, we ask that all the words that we hear that touch our heart is that we are loved, that you are wanted. We ask that you bless Pastor Leo as he gets ready to give a wonderful word of God that you have produced for him for us today. We ask all these things in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you so much, Jonathan. Appreciate that. Will you stand, please, for the word of God? I want to say, I forgot, big happy birthday to you, Steve. Steve's birthday today. You looking around. It's yours. It's only yours. Appreciate that. God bless you being here on your birthday. The word of God, Job chapter 42 and verses 1 through 6. Job 42, verses 1 through 6. Then Job replied to the Lord, I know that you can do all things. No purpose of yours can be dwarfed. You ask, who is this that obscures my plan without knowledge? Surely I spoke of things I did not understand, things too wonderful for me to know. You said, listen now, and I will speak. I will question you, and you shall answer me. My ears had heard of you, but now my eyes have seen you. Therefore, I despise myself and repent in dust and ashes. The word of God for the people of God, and everyone said, you may be seated in the house of the Lord. This is the seventh week of our sermon series and small group discussions, Biblical Characters Just Like Me. We're still in that feeling triad. How many of you are driven by your feelings? Anybody here? Driven by your feelings. Control more by the right hemisphere of your brain than the left. Today we meet someone just like you, who has a high capacity in the energy of the Enneagram type 4 nature. This series is using biblical narratives. We're going and diving into the Bible, along with using the Enneagram as a useful tool to help us in our spiritual transformation process by identifying our personality and also those strategies that we use to cope and to thrive in life. The fours that we find in the Bible include Joseph, Isaiah, Hosea, and Jeremiah. But the biblical narrative that really brings it home for us today is the focus on a famous character in the Bible, Job. Job's narrative is about spiritual maturity from an individualist mindset to a cosmic hope. A four is a self-absorbed, sensitive, creative, overanalyzer. And what we find in Job today is Job is preoccupied by what he had and what he lost. It has driven Job to the precipice of despair. One of the verses that really in Job that is always what I've stood out to me is Job chapter 3, verse 25. It says, what I always feared has happened to me. What I dreaded has come true. You see, the core fear of the four is the fear of having no identity or personal significance. Imagine what it's like. Job learns this valuable lesson that speaking tragically and dramatically is a part of a self-image that needs to be destroyed, let go of, and transformed by God. We must learn that there is power in our words. Just because we think it, we don't really have to say it. Proverbs 18, verse 21 says, what you say can mean life or death. Those who speak with care will be rewarded. See, fours often retreat within themselves and are known for their radical commitment to individualism, emphasizing the moral worth of the individual and prioritizing the needs of the individual over that of the needs of the group as a whole. The more self-focused we become, the less connected we become. The temptation of the four is to be too given to fantasy. This often leads to that feeling of uniqueness about who we are, separating us from the world. No one understands us, we say. Think about this. Connectedness. Connectedness is the missing element that is needed for the four. This could lead to immaturity, if you don't have it, and at worst, just wanting to give up. Job is a four in the sense that he is spending a lot of time, a significant amount of time, analyzing his feelings. Job's whole world, which was his identity, remember that. His whole world, which was his identity, collapsed and disappeared in a matter of days. As a child, fours may have felt abandoned or misunderstood by both parents or by both their nurturing and their protective figures. Imagine what it feels like for Job. In chapter 1 of Job, verses 2 and 3, it says, "And he had 7 sons, 3 daughters. He owned 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 yoke of oxen, and 500 donkeys, and had a large number of servants. He was," scripture says, "he was the greatest man of all the people of the East." There are 42 chapters in Job. And yet, by the time you read verse 20 of the first chapter, Job has lost everything. Everything. And although there is the loss of children, and there's the loss of the material goods and his own health, that's all indeed tragic. But Job is left internalizing questions about what it all means. Can God be praised in despair? Are we entitled to, quote, the good life? Is life a gift, or are we entitled to it? See, I believe there's a little bit of four in all of us. Sorrell, in the Enneagram and Spiritual Formation, says, quote, "The transformation issue for Job is not grieving what has been lost, but rather it is," quote, "identifying so deeply with what was previously meant to be enjoyed rather than to receive as an identity." Keep in mind as we study personality, you're not a number. You are not your personality. You are not your possessions. You are not what you do. But you are God's child. You are God's child, and you are deeply loved. You are completely forgiven, and you are totally accepted, period. Don't ever let go of that. That's who you are in Christ. Possessions, job, even this life will come to an end. This is not who you are. These are things that we can enjoy. One day, all of us will die. Nothing is permanent except our identity in Christ. Fours wrestle with the vice called envy. envy, wanting what everyone else has. Struggle with this and strive for the virtue which is emotional balance. Emotional balance. I want you to listen to this. Emotional balance. The state of being aware of our emotions, even enough, that is, to manage them in a way that is gentle, honest, and wise. I have to admit to you, I've been working on my four nature for a while here. And lately, specifically, the emotional balance. You see, sadness is one of those emotions that I have not yet become skillful in. I'm unskillful in coping with sadness. I don't like thinking about it. It was hard for me to just set into it. And I still, especially when it comes to my mom, I still cry a lot when I think about sadness. But emotional balance comes from having emotional intelligence combined with the intelligence that enables us to notice and to respond to emotions as they rise. It's important that we not push down our emotions. The first step in understanding, because this is a deep work that God has to do. This is not something that you can do, you or I can do. The first thing is self-observation. We must recognize ourselves behaving in a way that is not Christ-like. Let God show you this. The second thing is self-understanding. Self-understanding comes when we know our motives behind our behavior. And third is to cultivate awareness or presence, which facilitates a deepening of this transformation process. You see, there are holy practices that will help us get to the place where we can be emotionally balanced. For the four, it includes the downstream practices. These are those that come easier for the four: solitude and journaling. Solitude and journaling. If you're four, you want to practice this. Solitude provides you with a space to dream, a place to imagine, a place where you can think creatively. Fours need this. You have the gift to create beauty in the world. But you got to stop all the other things that's going on, right? Journaling will offer you a way to explore life. A way where you can write down what it means to you, the meaning of life, where you're able to release those things that keeps this inner monologue going. You can release it. The one thing you want to do is avoid self-preoccupation. It's not about you. It's not about me. That leads to arrogance when things are going good. I got this, right? Or when things go bad, it leads to depression because I don't got this, right? I don't have it at all. And yet we take the time to intercede for others that helps us to stay where it's not about us. The upstream practice. My wife was saying, and this has come to mind, when she said, you got a lot of four friends. Well, it's not that I'm asking to have four friends. Fours, which I'm trying to do better at, fours want some joy. So the number one thing for a four is feasting. Remember, that's what a seven likes to do. Well, that's what a four needs. We got to get them out of the house. We got to get them out of this, you know, their fantasy. And we got to get you to where you can have some joy. A time of fellowship, a time to be thankful. See, connecting with others so that you can cultivate some joy, some peace, and some thanksgiving is a must for a four, for that four nature in all of us. A four needs joy in their life. See, this practice will help you get out of yourself and force you away from the extreme melancholy that a four is at home with. That's why it was very difficult for me throughout my life to hang with a four, because I didn't know how to deal with sadness, and a four just felt at home with sadness. I'm like, my God, no, you're going to suck me into that, and I would run. And when I realized what the four wanted was, they wanted that joy they saw in me. And I was like, I'd love for you to have this joy, but I'm so afraid you're going to take all my joy. I'm learning, fours, for us to embrace one another. Let's schedule for the four in us, let's schedule some fellowship time. Schedule some time for some regular feasting with some consistent people so that you can start building that trust that you need and someone getting to know you. Next week, I want you to read John chapter 3, verses 1 through 2. We're going to talk about the type 5 next week. John chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. 1 through 12. This is the scripture that the Lord gave me for the four nature in me. I want you to listen to this carefully. I remember preaching from this when I was 16 years old. Psalm 30. I will exalt you, O Lord, for you have drawn me up and have not caused my foes to rejoice over me. O Lord, my God, I cried to you and you healed me. O Lord, you brought up my soul from the grave. You have kept me alive that I should not go down in the pit. Sing to the Lord, O you saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. For his anger, this is one of my favorite scriptures right here, but his anger endures but a moment. In his favor is life. And this is the kicker here. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Joy comes in the morning. In my prosperity, I said, I will never be moved. Lord, by your favor, you have set me strong as a mountain. You hid your face, and I was terrified. I cried to you, O Lord, and to the Lord I made my supplication. What profit is there in my death if I go down to the pit? Will the dust give you thanks? Will it declare your truth? Hear, O Lord, and be gracious to me. Lord, be my helper. For you have turned my mourning into dancing. You heard him sing the song. That was pretty neat, the workout. I appreciate that, Sean. That worked perfectly. You have turned my mourning into dancing. You have put off the sackcloth, girded me with gladness, and so my glory may sing praise to you and not be silent. O Lord, my God, I give thanks to you forever. Can you see Job? Why he said, my ears have heard of you. How many of us go by what we've heard about God? Heard what God can do, heard about it. But notice what he says. He says, but now, my eyes have seen you. Once that four nature take the risk of experiencing God by connecting with others to allow the joy of the Lord to be their strength, they'll never see God the same again. I invite you, fours, the four nature in you, take that risk. It's not easy. The connection that you make will make all the difference. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, thank you so very much just for letting us know how much you love us, how special we are to you. We have always been special to you. But we forget. And so we ask today for that reconnect. If you're here today and you need that, I want you to just pray. Or just pray. Pray this prayer with me. Say, Lord, come on, say it with me. Say, Lord, thank you for loving me. Thank you for connecting with me. Sending your son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross so that I may have joy. Joy. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and be my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer, you know that God heard you and that God's already connected with you. Will you stand with me today and let's sing together as God ministers to us? If you don't have a church home, I would love to be your pastor. Text me, 832-773-4901. Let's connect. Let's be on this journey together. Let God minister to you now.
When I think about the Lord, how he saved me, how he raised me, how he filled me with the Holy Ghost, how he healed me to the uttermost. Solid ground, it makes me want to shout, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, Lord, you're worthy of all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. It makes me want to shout.
Praise. Here we go. It makes me want to shout.
and all the praise. It makes me want to shout, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you're worthy of all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. It makes me want to shout.
Pulls all the joy wherever it was in you out and just say, Lord, we thank you. Thank you, Sean, so very much. Thank you, guys. Oh, we bless you so very much. All of you guys. You don't see these guys back there, I don't think. Stand up. Let them see you, too. We got our drummer, JC. We got Leo playing the bass, and you got Oscar on keys. Isn't that a blessing? I want you to just let God continue to use you. Be full of joy this week. Call somebody, talk to somebody, and maybe just connect with them. Just connect with them and invite God into that fellowship. And enjoy some joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Thank you. Look forward to seeing you next week.